Good morning, everybody. You're watching Iowa Live, and we love talking about what's happening in our community. And there's something that's been going on all month long and continues to lead up to Vegan Fest. So we're very excited to have the president of VegLife Des Moines, Amy Lubert, joining us this morning. Thank you so much for being here.
Welcome.
Thanks for having
such a great
me.
Event.
Yes. Okay. So this is third annual Vegan Fest.
Vegan Fest.
It gets bigger and bigger every year.
Yeah.
Right?
It does. In case people have no idea what we're talking about, explain what's coming up at the end of this month.
Yeah. So April 27th, 11 a.m., 5 p.m., 6 hours long. It's a full day of food and fun. Over 50 vendors are going to be at the atrium and Kohl's Common. So we're expanding to both inside and outside. So you got food trucks outside and then inside food vendors, merchandise, and other nonprofits. There's also speakers, workshops, and cooking demos happening all throughout the day as well.
Because there's a lot more to it than just food,
yes.
Right? And so kind of talk a little bit about what some of those other things are.
Sure. So if someone's being vegan or is a vegan, they're also not eating animal products, but they're also thinking about what they're wearing. So there will be clothing vendors, but also what they're using for soap products or makeup. They're looking for things that are not tested on animals and don't include animal products. There's also a lot of zero waste stuff in there too, so some sustainability as well.
Yeah.
Very nice. You can definitely tell that you're growing over 50 vendors and using inside space, outside space. But obviously there's a need in our community for this. But why was it important for you to start something like this?
Well, I've been vegan a really long time, almost 18 years. And when I first started it, there wasn't really a community of people. And so I think having that community is really important for people, because in Iowa, it can be not the norm to be vegan. And so maybe you're the only person in your family, the only person you know. So we want to really expand it and show people this is something that you can do in Iowa. It's becoming easier to do. And we want people to feel like they have that community. Because if you have a community, you might stick with something longer and feel that support.
And there's a lot more available to people now, which is exciting. And a lot of it you're not aware of. So it's nice to be able to kind of go to one place and have it all under one roof and be exposed to what is available in the area.
Yeah,
I think you're absolutely right. We come from a state where it's meat and potatoes, right?
And bacon.
Other festivals that celebrate other things that maybe people aren't completely in agreement with. Or why should people try a vegan lifestyle or maybe incorporate some of those ideas into their life?
Definitely. People don't have to be vegan to come, so I want to make that clear. This is a festival for everyone. We hope you'll try it out. People choose to eat vegan or be vegan for lots of reasons. The health reasons are there. Also, the environmental impact is less when you're eating plants directly versus animals eat plants, and then you have to process the animals, and so there's just a lot more waste there.
Right.
And then also for the ethical reasons, some people choose for that reason.
Yeah, and I think it's nice that you just pointed out that you don't have to be vegan to enjoy what all you have to offer at an event like this, because I think it's nice. I have found I am not vegan, but I prefer, I love plant-based foods and all of the things that go with that. So you can mix that into what you whatever your lifestyle is, which I think is great.
Yeah, definitely.
Well, I think you probably appreciate the people that aren't vegan who come and they eat various things or learn things. They're like, whoa, I never knew.
Exactly.
Something you're doing this year, which I absolutely love, is a restaurant tour.
Because
a lot of times you feel like you have to go to one section of, the grocery store, or I can only eat, sprouts, and that's that's my life.
Or I can only get the salad. All that's available when you go to a restaurant is a salad.
Is a salad, right. And there's restaurants now raising their hand, courtesy of VegLife, saying, no, we want to be a part of this. And we're going to show that there are options out there. So talk about the restaurant tour, because we're in the fourth week, correct?
Fourth week, 6 weeks long. And I just want to guarantee everyone, I'm not eating sprouts. I rarely eat sprouts.
You can take it way beyond the sprouts, right?
I love it.
That's
I eat a lot of things.
So these are the last 3 weeks, because this is restaurant week going on for three more weeks. And this is my other favorite part, because you're thinking, oh, you're going to go and it's going to be one of those very green restaurants and things like that. This is across the board.
Yeah.
Everybody's getting involved in
exactly.
this.
We actually had to turn some folks away because it was just too
really?
Big. It's amazing. The response from the community has been awesome. And what happens when on the tour, because people have asked, what happens? You're going to dine at a restaurant like normal. And so you're going to go in. You don't get a tour of the restaurant. I get that question a lot. You don't eat as a group. You go with whoever you like, either yourself or with your friends or your family. Some people can eat the vegan menu. Some people can choose not to eat it. It's totally up to you. What we ask for the restaurants to do is have at least three options. So you have some choices, and they provide that to every person who walks in. So everybody should see the vegan menu and be able to try it if they want. you of course don't have to. Right. We're not making you.
Do the restaurants tailor something special for this period of time? Are these things that they already have on their menu? I mean, will they go beyond mm-hmm. just this period of 6 weeks?
Yeah, so some of them have very expansive vegan menus and will offer all of that on the day of. Some people are making very special things. So Table 128 was an example last week or a week ago who had some amazing options that they don't normally have. And we're hopeful that maybe they'll think about bringing them back. That is a question we ask them is, do you think you'll keep these options around? Because we'd love to see it expanded in Des Moines, have more vegan options out there.
Absolutely. Yeah. Okay, so since we're going into the fourth week, what's been the reaction so far?
Really positive. Okay. People that are attending, so people like me who want to eat great food.
Yeah.
I love it because I get to eat all the food.
Sample it all.
Yep. and then we have a post survey for the restaurant owners because we really care about what's their experience as
right.
well. Some of them have served up to 100 dishes a night of vegan food,
wow.
which is more than they do normally.
Wow.
So we're really seeing a lot of people take part in the tour and try it out. One meal doesn't hurt to try something new and give those restaurants some support. They're all locally owned as well, which we love.
And it's nice because a lot of times you go out to dinner and not everybody has the same taste, and you don't have to just go to one that caters to one or the other. It's something for everybody.
Yeah. Exactly.
Nice.
To me, it's just raising awareness and realizing Des Moines is awesome and we have great options out there. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you just have to be pointed to those options and say, this is where they are and it's okay. Okay, so who's a part of the restaurant today?
Today is Gusto Pizza.
Restaurateur Gusto Pizza.
Yes, all four of their locations, and they're doing a great pizza, a Francesco Pizza, a Harvester Pizza, which has some butternut squash on it, so I'm really excited about that.
Yum. And the crust is like a tapioca type of
not the
mix, isn't it?
Or the cheese, you mean?
The cheese, that's what I'm thinking of. The cheese, not the...
the cheese is a vegan cheese that they buy, which is called Daiya. It's a brand of cheese. It's really tasty.
Okay, might have to give it a try. So all of their locations today, you have three different options if you want to try vegan pizza today.
Yes.
But if we want to try Vegan Fest, mm-hmm. give us all those details.
Sure, so it's April 27th, 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. There's a $5 fee at the door for adults, 17 and under are free.
Okay.
And it's got food vendors and also merchandise, speakers, workshops, cooking demos. We've got yoga going on and kids Zumba. It's just going to be awesome.
Talk about some of the speakers that you have coming.
Yeah, we have two coming from around the country. One is Jenny Messina. She's a registered dietitian. She's written 8 books on vegan and nutrition. She's going to answer all your questions about, can I get everything I need on a vegan diet?
Right.
Because
mm-hmm.
people have those concerns.
Right.
And then the other one is a lifestyle influencer. She's a vlogger on YouTube, and she really focuses on vegan on a budget and making it easy. She's got 3 little kids.
Oh, I love that.
And she's all about just, what can I do to get in and out of that grocery store, get back home, make the food that's healthy, and my kids will actually eat it. So we're really excited to have Monique Koch with us as well. She's the Brown Vegan on YouTube. And then we have workshops. We have local folks leading these workshops who are experts on vegan and athleticism. So if you're a bodybuilder, there's lots of vegan bodybuilders, mm-hmm. but there's that question, how do I get that protein? So they're going to answer that question.
Wow,
we've got teen panel, how do I be a vegan teen? High school as a teenager,
That's great.
What do I do at those parties and things? So there's going to be 5 teenagers on a panel talking about that as well. Parenting as vegan, zero waste, intersectionality in veganism. So we got lots of things going on at this fest.
And that makes it a lot easier for people to just embrace all of those offerings, just the more they know. Because a lot of times it's like, well, I don't really know what to do, or it's always the same stuff. And this really opens up their eyes to all of the different things that are available and that they can do themselves, which is nice.
Yep. You can do what you do today just by eating vegan and being vegan. You can just transfer. No reason to change. If you're already like an athlete, for example, you can just do that vegan.
Yeah, and it's exciting to see how much it's grown over the last few years, you know, with the restaurants wanting to be involved and just the event itself. And I think it's a fabulous event that you've decided to put together.
Thank you.
All right. Well, you got to see it for yourself. You can enjoy it at Gusto Pizza all day today, but the big event coming up at the end of the month, if people want more details, where's the best place for them to go?
So veglifedesmoines.org.
Yes.
Or we're on Facebook and Instagram.
Love it.
Find us there.
Okay. So get all those details, get on the website and learn more so you can be part of Vegan Fest. So we're talking, as you see there, over 50 vendors. We're going to have one of those vendors joining us in the kitchen for our treats and eats later on this morning as well. So we'll show you how easy and tasteful it can be as well. Thank you so much
Very
for joining
nice.
Us this
Thanks,
morning.
Guys. Thank you.
Great things are happening. We're going to continue to talk about them here on Iowa Live, but we're going to